And I'm so excited po to be here in this Bible study. And nakakatawa po talaga that every Wednesday, we have hundreds of people na talagang very faithful to learn and to study the Word of God, specifically po dito sa book study natin. And again, as Jocelyn mentioned po, no, ako po si Jera. And yung wife ko po si Virna, and I have 3 kids. And praise God, kasi alam niyo, wala po yung mga bata dito sa bahay. Yeah. Nando sila sa kabilang nasa in-laws ko, so tahimik po dito ngayon. Ayan, okay. So allow me po to share my screen before I proceed. Sige po. And I also like to greet po ang ating mga regular attendees, especially po yung mga nasa iba't ibang lugar, Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, and also yung mga nag-a-attend po sa atin from other parts of the world, shout out po sa inyo. And sobrang nabe-bless po kami every time na nakikita po namin kayo dito na talagang willing na willing makinig po at umattend itong book study natin. So as we warm up po our discussion, meron lang po akong i-play na video, and I hope that it will play correctly or properly. And kung alam niyo po yung movie na to, just please type in the chat box po kung ano pong title ng movie na to. Sorry. Praise God. So tama po ang inyong mga sagot. Ang title po ng movie na yan ay Brave Heart. And alam nyo ba na itong movie po na to ay napakaganda po, at I know that nakita nyo po yung joy sa face po ni nung bida po, no, si Wallace or si Mel, no, Gibson, na talagang nakita natin yung joy ay yung celebration na meron po sila during that time nung movie na yon. And in the same way, no, nung nagfall po ang Babylon, na nagfall po ang Babylon, ito po ay nagre-represent ng destruction ng lahat ng masasama, yung evil and demonic in the present world system. And so, wag po tayong masusurprise that when something as dangerous, sila po, nung napakinggan po natin last Wednesday po, no, yung mga Antichrist, sobrang sama po nung Antichrist kingdom. And same thing with us as Christians. When we witness po the fall of Babylon, kailangan po itong i-celebrate, and God's people should rejoice. And yan po ang pag-uusapan natin this evening, because ang title po ng ating message is Heavenly Celebration for the Lamb's Wedding. Again, yung Revelation chapter 4, verse 18 po, dealt primarily with the events of the Great Tribulation. And para sa akin po, if I will rephrase it, alam nyo, hindi ko po siya tatawagin Great Tribulation. I will call it Ungreat Tribulation. Because alam naman po natin that during that time, as we learn about it, ano, sobrang hirap po. Hindi ka makabili ng mga pagkain, pag wala kang Mark of the Beast, tapos yung mga tao na nagpa-follow kay Christ, ang ginagawa nila, pinapatay po nila. And sobrang hirap, and sobrang sama po ng mundo. Actually, sinabi nga po doon, di ba, the great immorality. So yun po yung experience nila. And I remember po, doon sa Matthew, sinabi po ni Jesus, sabi po sa Matthew chapter 24, verse 4 to 8, Jesus answered and said to them, "See to it that no one misleads you." Jesus is talking about the end times. Sabi po sa verse 5, "For many will come in my name, saying, 'I am the Christ.'" Ito po yung Antichrist. At ano pong gagawin dito ng mga Antichrist? They will mislead many people. Katulad po nung natutunan po natin in the previous chapter. And sabi po, and you will be hearing of wars. Marami pong digmaan and rumors of wars. And sabi po nung, see that you are not alarmed, for those things must take place. Pero sabi nung, but that is not yet the end. Ano po mangyayari during end times? For nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there will be famines. Magkakaroon po ng kagutuman. Because yun nga, pag wala kang tatak, hindi ka makakabili ng pagkain. Magkakaroon po ng shortage sa food. And earthquakes in various places. And sabi po lang, but all these things are merely the beginning of birth pain. Simula pa lang daw po yun. And yun po, ano, sabi po dyan. And then sabi, then, tutuloy po natin, verse 9. And then they will hand you over to tribulation. The ungreat tribulation for me. And kill you, papatayin ka. And you will be hated by all nations because of my name. Ayaw ka ng mga tao dahil sa pangalan ni Christ. At ano mangyayari? And that time, many will fall away. And they will betray one another and hate one another. At ito pa mangyayari. And many false prophets will rise up. Mga pulang propeta. Babangon po sila, mag-rule sila sa mundo na to, and they will mislead many people. At nakakalungkot po dito, and because lawlessness is increased, most people's love will become cold. Imagine that time, ano? Kung maabutan man natin itong situation na to, yung pinag-uusapan natin na tribulation, ano kaya yung mararamdaman natin? Susunod ba tayo dun sa maling katuruan? I-forsake ba natin yung beliefs na pinangahawakan natin ngayon? Yung mga natutunan kaya natin dito sa Revelation Book Study, maia-apply kaya natin siya. So yan po, hated by all nations, fall away, betray one another, hate one another, false prophets, and love will become cold. Kaya nga sabi po sa 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 1, sabi kay Timothy, but realize this, that in the last days, difficult times will come. Difficult times will come. Bakit? Kasi people will be lovers of self, lovers of money, boastful, arrogant, slanderers, disobedient to parents, ungrateful, unholy, unloving, irreconcilable, malicious, gossip, so on and so forth, self-control, holding to a form of godliness, although they have denied the power, avoid such people as this. So yun po yung mangyayari during the time of tribulation. And then here comes the Revelation Chapter 19, verse 1. Ito po yung pag-uusapan natin. After these things. Ano po yung after these things? Yun po yung mga na-mention ko kanina. Lahat ng bagay na yon, ito po yung mangyayari. And sobrang, it's my privilege po to deliver this message sa inyong lahat. Because in every movies, ano, when we watch movies, lagi pong may climax. And sabi po, this part of Revelation, this is the climax of the book. And tingnan po natin, ano po mangyari after these things? Ano po yung after these things? Again, yun po yung mga nabanggit ko po kanina. And makikita po natin dito sa chapter 19 that there is a noticeable change. Talagang magkakaroon ng transition. Di ba? Magkakaroon ng transition from tribulation. And then mamaya po, i-discuss po natin. From tribulation, there will be a celebration. Okay? So yung ginamit po dito na after these things, ang literal meaning po nito is metatauta. Literally means after this or after this thing. So ginagamit po itong phrase na to when there's something, such an event or person which follows something previously indicated. Which is yun po yung previous chapter. Yung mga pinag-aralan po natin in the past weeks. Okay? So sabi po rito, after these things, ano po nangyari? I heard something like a loud voice of a great multitude in heaven. Yun po, no? May narinig po si John. Something, hindi po siya sigurado, something like a loud voice of a great multitude in heaven. Alam nyo, nung nabasa ko to, I realized, ano? When God wants to send something to us, kahit gaano pa kalayo yung heaven, hindi natin alam, no, kung gaano kalayo yung heaven dito sa mundo na kinakatayuan natin. Pero when God wants to send something, maririnig at maririnig po natin ito. Hindi po siya malabo. Sabi po dyan, it is like a loud voice of a great multitude in heaven saying. Ayan, pause po muna tayo dyan. Ano? So gusto nyo bang malaman kung ano po yung sinasabi nila dito? Ano yung naririnig ni John? Na loud voice of a great multitude in heaven? Ito po yun. Ito po yung sinasabi niya. Okay? Sige po. So ito po yung pag-uusapan natin. Revelation chapter 19 verse 1 to 6 po muna tayo. So i-cover po natin ngayon ay short chapter lang po, 1 to 10. And then next week, no? So wag po kayo mawawala because napakaganda po ng topic natin. It's about Jesus riding, 'di ba? Riding on the horse, I guess. Yan. So ayan po, Revelation chapter 19 verse 1 to 6. Basahin po natin. Hallelujah, salvation, glory and power belong to our God because His judgments are true and righteous. For He has judged the great prostitute who was corrupting the earth with their sexual immorality. Yan po yung chapter 8, 17 or 18. And He has avenged the blood of His bondservants on her. Verse 3, and a second time they said, Hallelujah, her smoke rises forever and ever. And the 24 elders and the four living creatures fell down and worshiped God who sits on the throne, saying, Amen, Hallelujah. And a voice came from the throne, saying, Give praise to our God, all you His bond servants, you who fear Him, the small and the great. Then I heard something like the voice of a great multitude, and like the sound of many waters, and like the sound of mighty peals of thunder, saying, Hallelujah, for the Lord our God, the Almighty, reigns. Can you identify what is the one word that was repeated 4 times in this passage? Please type on the chat box. Ano po yung isang word na inulit-ulit po dito ng 4 beses? Okay? Sige po. Please type on the chat box. Okay? Ano po yung isang word na paulit-ulit pong sinabi dito? Actually, 4 times. Yan. Praise God. So tama po kayo. The word is Hallelujah. Okay? So alam nyo, itong salita na to, yung hallelujah, sa atin sometimes it's just a normal word. But you know, as I was studying it and I was researching, praying about it, alam nyo, amazing tong salita na to, mamaya pag-uusapan natin. Yan po, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Okay? 4 beses. And alam nyo ba, The literal meaning of this is praise the Lord. Alam po natin lahat yan. Praise the Lord. Pero ito po yung very interesting. Alam nyo ba na yung salitang hallelujah, it occurs in the New Testament only 4 times. Okay? 4 beses lang po siyang nabanggit sa New Testament yung salitang hallelujah. Wala po tayong makikita sa ibang book. Kung hindi po, dito lang po sa Revelation chapter 19 verse 1, verse 3, verse 4, and verse 6. Yan po yung binasa natin kanina. And you know, ma-realize po natin kung paano po pin-reserve, 'di ba? Itong word na to sa pagbabalik po ni Jesus Christ. Nung malapit na pong dumating si Jesus Christ after the tribulation, nung malapit na dumating si Jesus Christ, this word, okay? This word of hallelujah. Okay? Nabanggit po yung salitang hallelujah after many years of waiting. Nasabi nila yung salitang hallelujah. And sabi po rito, this is the biblical hallelujah chorus. Bakit po sinabing hallelujah chorus? Kasi ang mga nagbabanggit po nito ay 3 group. Okay? Number 1, the saints in heaven. The saints in heaven, they are saying hallelujah. The 24 elders who are sitting in the throne in heaven, sabi po nila hallelujah. And also the great multitude. Okay, the great multitude is also saying hallelujah. Hallelujah chorus, sabay-sabay po sila. Kaya nga po sabi, in a loud voice, in a multitude. And ang good news po dito, we can join with that heavenly throng today in anticipation of what God will do in the future. As believers po, no, hindi na po natin kailangan antayin na dumating po yung time na to ng Revelation, itong part ng chapter na to, para sabihin po natin yung hallelujah. Kahit po madami tayong mga pinagdadaanan dito sa mundo, di ba? For some of us, feeling natin yung buhay natin, we are already experiencing tribulation. We are experiencing financial crisis. We are experiencing relationship problem. We are experiencing job loss. Or maybe your business is not prospering. Piling mo tribulation na. Alam mo, ang good news dito, we don't need to wait for this time sa pagbabalik ni Jesus Christ. We could celebrate now. We could say, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Kahit marami po akong problema, alam ko that God is in control. Praise the Lord. Kahit marami akong problema, alam ko, in the near future, maayos din to because I have God in my heart. Sige, tuloy po natin. Ano? Sabi, Revelation chapter 19, verse 1 to 6. Makikita po natin dyan, sabi po dyan, salvation, verse 1, salvation, glory, and power belong to our God. Yung hallelujah po nila, ito po yung pinanggagalingan nito. Na-realize po nila that the Lord, di ba? That the Lord is our salvation. That God is glorious. That God is powerful. Power belong to our God. And then sa verse 2, because His judgment are true and righteous. Okay? Makikita po natin dyan that God is just. God is righteous. Yung mga nabanggit po niyan, yun po yung mga attributes po ni Lord. Attributes po ni God. And pag na-realize po natin yung attributes ni God, kahit po sobrang hirap po ng pinagdadaanan natin sa buhay, masasabi po natin yung salitang hallelujah. And pag dumating man po tayo sa point that we don't feel like worshiping God, parang ayaw natin siya i-worship, again, try to remind ourselves with these attributes that God is our Savior, that God is glorious, that God is all-powerful, that God is just, He is true, He is righteous. Yun po yung mga kailangan po natin gawin so that we could praise our God just like this, shouting hallelujah. Tuloy po natin, sabi po sa verse 2, di ba pa naalala po natin last Wednesday, sobrang sama po ng mundo. And ito na po yung mangyayari ngayon. Because His judgments are true and righteous. Ano pong ginawa ni God? For He has judged the great prostitute. Yung po yung system na na-discuss po last Wednesday. The great prostitute who was corrupting the earth with their sexual immorality. Akala po nila forever na sila mag-reign. Pero dadating po yung panahon, they will face the judgment. Okay? And sabi po dyan, ito po yung nakakatuwa po sa Lord. And He has avenged the blood of His bond servants on her. Hindi po kinalimutan ni Lord yung mga followers niya na namatay because of His name. Ayan po yun, no? He has avenged the blood of His bond servants on her. So hindi po sayang yung mga buhay ng mga taong nag-follow sa Kanya. Na kahit buhay po nila yung kapalit, binigay po nila para kay Kristo. Kasi alam po nila that one day, okay, the Lord will reign. The Lord will judge this great prostitute or this immoral person or this immoral system na nag-reign during tribulation. And tuloy po natin. Sabi po dyan sa verse 3. Okay? Yan, I remember po. Okay, sorry po. Yan. So again, no, napaka-importante po tayo as Christians to remember the attributes of God. Kasi kahit gaano kahirap po yung situation natin sa buhay, yun po yung magpapaalala sa atin that of this word na hallelujah, praise the Lord. Kaya nga po, meron po akong nakitang material. Pwede niyo po itong i-search sa internet. Sabi po dito, 60 attributes of God. Yeah, pwede nyo pong i-search sa link. Makikita nyo po dito. Ito po yung mga attributes po ni Lord. God is absolute. God is accessible. God is all-knowing. God is gracious. God is compassionate. God is love. God is practical. God is spirit. God is unity. Ayan po, 60 po yan. So when we have these attributes of God, mare-remind po tayo to praise God. To give our worship to the Lord. We could say, hallelujah. Ayan po. So, ayan po. Again po, balik po tayo dito. Sabi, He has avenged the blood of His bond servants on her. Remember sa Romans, sabi po rito, never take your own revenge, beloved, but leave room for the wrath of God. Kasi, for it is written, vengeance is mine, I will repay, says the Lord. Diba tayo as Christians? Diba? By nature. Diba? When someone hurt us, pag tayo'y pinagmaritisan, I don't know if it's the right term, ano? Pinagchismisan, ano? Sometimes gusto natin agad bumawi. Gusto natin, kailangan, ginawa niya sa akin to, ninakawan niya ako. Nanakawan ko din yung kaibigan ko. Sinaktan niya ako physically, babalikan ko rin siya physically. Sinaktan niya ako emotionally, na-hurt ako sa nasabi niya. Gusto natin balikan din. Pero ito po yung pangako sa atin ng Panginoon. The vengeance is mine, I will repay. And yun po yung nangyari, no? When the Lord judge, okay? The immoral system ng merong tribulation, ito po yung nangyari. Ang vengeance po. And after po the vengeance, yun po yung pag-uusapan natin eh. Na importante po that we celebrate, di ba? Yung heavenly celebration for the Lamb's wedding. And mamaya po pag-uusapan natin sa verse 6 to 10, ano ba yung mga apat na bagay na dapat po natin i-celebrate? Four reasons for celebration. Okay? Number one, because the power of God has vanquished evil. Yan po yung sa verse 1 to 3. We need to celebrate because the Lord God reigns. We need to celebrate because the marriage of the Lamb has come. We need to celebrate because the marriage supper begins. Ayan po. So balikan po natin yung verse. Ayan. So sabi po, verse 7, let's rejoice and be glad and give the glory to Him because the marriage of the Lamb has come. Okay? So kailangan daw mag-rejoice tayo. Kasi dumating na po, 'di ba? Bumalik na po, pabalik na po si Jesus Christ and the marriage of the Lamb has come. Okay? Sabi po diyan, when the King of Kings conquers evil, tinalo po ng King of Kings yung evil at nagsimula na po siya mag-reign dito sa mundo. And yung bride po niya, 'di ba? The bride, the church, which is us, 'di ba? Will stand at his side and reign with him. At pagsabi daw po, pag tayo po ay nag-reign na po beside Jesus, alam niyo po mangyayari, the church will no longer be marred with conflict. Hindi na po natin may experience yung conflict. Wala na pong division among the church members, among the church leaders. Wala na pong immorality. Wala na pong kalungkutan within the church. And yung mga bagay po na yon ay kailangan po nating i-celebrate. Kaya nga sabi po ni Paul sa Ephesians chapter 5 verse 27, sabi po diyan that he might present to himself the church in all her glory. Alam niyo mangyari, having no spot or wrinkle or any such thing but that she would be holy and blameless. So yun po yung pangako ng Panginoon that when we reign beside Jesus Christ, well, blameless na po tayo, no spot, no wrinkle. And tayo po ay magiging holy. And what a cause for celebration. What a cause for celebration. That one day, we will reunite with God, with Jesus, di ba? Hindi na makikita yung kasalanan natin. We are already blameless. Sabi po rito, four reasons for celebration. We celebrate because the power of God has vanquished evil. The Lord God reigns. The marriage of the Lamb has come, and the marriage supper begins. Sabi po rito, then he said to me, okay? Sabi po diyan sa verse 9, blessed are those who are invited to the wedding feast of the Lamb. Okay? Excited ba kayo? Itong sa wedding feast na to? Okay, number one, we will say our hallelujah to God, and then He will judge the immoral system of the world during the time of tribulation. And then the wedding, okay, yun na-discuss po natin ngayon. And then the next one, siyempre pag may wedding, pag may celebration, meron pong feast. Okay? Wedding feast of the Lamb. Okay? So ako minsan, tayo mga Pilipino, no? Mahilig po tayong kumain. Di ba? We love eating. Okay? Iba nga, di ba? Sa D group, excited lang pag may pagkain. De, joke lang po. So yan, di ba? Imagine the gathering for that grand supper na pagbalik po ni Jesus Christ. We will eat together. Ini-imagine ko, no? Parang, is it a literal banquet? Is it a long table? Meron kayang sanggyup? Okay? Is it, meron bang, magsuserve ba sila ng best international food delicacy? Is it a multi-course dinner? Or an extravagant buffet? No? Parang asarap mag-imagine, di ba? But you know what? The great banquet will be about not the menu, but the master. What a cause for celebration. Sabi po sa Matthew 20, ito po yung sinasabi sa Matthew 25 verse 29, na sinabi, yung kausap po ni Jesus Christ yung mga disciples, sabi po dyan, but I say to you, I will not drink of this fruit of the vine from now on until that day when I return, until that day when I drink it with you new in my Father's kingdom. What a cause for celebration. Yan. As we continue, okay, sabi po ni Charles Swindoll, with the whole church glorified and united in the kingdom of God, sabi po dyan, Christ will take his seat with the saints. Si Christ po, uupo po with us and enjoy that long anticipated face-to-face fellowship with those he loves. Are you excited that one day we will be reunited with Christ and kakain po tayo together? Diba? Imagine, it's a long table together with the church members. Yung mga, tas kakausapin mo si Jesus Christ. Sabihin mo, Lord, kamusta ka? I miss you. Alam mo ba, nung time na I'm struggling on something, iyang-hiya ako sa'yo. But right now, I'm with you face-to-face fellowship with those he loves. So yun po, no? Yun po yung we are all looking forward on this day. Okay? The power of God will vanquish evil. Yung mga na-discuss po natin na mga earthly horrors, one day it will gone. And then, pagbalik po ni Jesus Christ, the Lord God will reigns. Remember that our God reigns. At kahit ano pang situation ng business mo ngayon, ng relationship mo, or maybe you're praying for someone, okay? Yung romance na iniisip mo, hindi nag-prosper. Tanda mo, the Lord God will reign. The Lord God reigns. And remember, okay? So verse 3. So number 3, the marriage of the Lamb has come. Remember that the Lamb is worthy of your worship. Si God lang ang worthy ng ating worship. Hindi po yung relationship. It's not about the money. It's not about the wealth. Lahat ng bagay na po yan, mawawala po yan. At ang worthy lang po ng ating hallelujah is only Jesus Christ. And third, remember that supper is being served and that you are invited. Okay? One day, okay? Yung supper, isa-serve po yan sa atin at tayo po ay invited dun po sa great wedding supper of the Lamb. And I remember po, nung bata pa po ako, paggabi na, no? Nung mga batang 90s, yung mga bata po, pa naglalaro sa labas yan, inaabot niya ng alas 6 ng gabi, alas 7 ng gabi, kasi mas masarap maglaro pag gabi kasi alam mo bakit, makakapagtagu-taguan kayo. Tapos, pag madilim na, alas 7 na, alam mo yung mangyayari? Yung parents, tatawagin ka, di ba? Jera, uwi na! Kakain na tayo ng dinner. And hindi pwede na pagpasok mo sa pinto, uupo ka agad. Kakain ka with your parents, with your family. Ano sasabihin sa'yo ng nanay mo? Ano sasabihin sa'yo ng tatay mo? Mag-wash ka muna ba? Maglinis ka muna. And same thing with us. Before we sit to enjoy the feast, we need to wash ourselves. We need to cleanse ourselves with all the sins that we have. And magagawa lang po natin yon na tayo po ay magiging malinis in the face of God by accepting the invitation of salvation that only God, that only Jesus can offer. And if you are that person na gusto mo that one day you will have the dinner, di ba, with Jesus Christ, and gusto mong isurrender yung sarili mo, gusto mong tanggapin si Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, may I invite you now for a prayer. Sige po, let's close our eyes and pray. Dear God, ina-admit ko po na ako po ay makasalanan. Please cleanse my heart. Because I want, Lord, that one day I will meet you face to face in a banquet. I will eat with you. And I can only do that if I will surrender my life to you. Please come to me and help me to be a good person. Help me to follow you. Tulungan mo ako na mamuhay ng naaayon sa'yo. Patawarin mo ako sa aking mga kasalanan. And I accept you as my Lord and personal Savior. And let's continue our prayer. Father God, we thank you for this evening. Thank you, Lord, for your promise, O Lord, na even, Lord, na dumating yung time ng tribulation, we don't know kung buhay pa kami noon or maybe the next generation, O Lord. Lord, maraming salamat because we know in just one click, you will come again and reign in this earth. You will redeem your people from the evil one. And one day, we will be reunited in your presence. Excited na kami, Panginoon. Isang araw, mahahawakan ka namin. Yayakapin ka namin. Sasabihin namin sa iyo, Lord, we love you. We praise you. And you deserve our hallelujah. Praise be to God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Again po, meron na po tayong katanungan mula kay Ma'am Sylvia. So ito na po. And yes, we are looking forward to be reunited with Jesus. But is it a sin to want to be with Him now? To wish nakasama ka na niya? Okay po, COS team, let's go. Po. Kung gusto mauna.
Ayon ni Jera yan.
Alright. Go, Brother Jera. Ikaw na daw po ang mauna.
Nagpa-pop up sa akin eh. Unmute ko na daw eh. Ayan. So, ang question po ni Ate Sylvia. Yes, you are looking forward to be reunited with Jesus. Asa na? Wala. Sorry. Be reunited with Jesus.
Basahin ko po. Okay na po.
Is it a sin to want to be with Him now? To wish na kasama ka na niya. Okay. Okay. Ate Sylvia, can I ask for a follow-up question? What do you mean po na kasama ka na niya? I mean, is it a sin to want to be with Him now?
Sometimes when you are experiencing, you are very down or experiencing many challenges, sometimes you just wish that you were already up there with Him. So is that a sin to do that, to have feelings like that?
Doc, may lang po ako kumakatok po. Wait lang po. May kumakatok sa pinto namin. Sorry po, wait lang. Ate Sylvia, assistant.
Okay. Ay, may kumakatok din. Dali. Ay, wala palang pintuan dito. Opo, Ma'am Sylvia, thank you for that great question kasi hindi ka nag-iisa talagang sometimes, no? pag nakikita natin itong mundo to, how broken it is, how much there's pain and suffering in this world, especially when it's your own pain and suffering, parang sabi ko, Lord, sa sarap siguro pag nasa heaven na, no, wala nang problema. Alam niyo po, hindi po kayo nag-isa kasi even si Paul, 'di ba sinabi niya 'yan na parang better it is to be ano away from the body but with the Lord, 'di ba? Parang he himself was in one of the letters wrote na parang it is really much better to be with the Lord, 'di ba? So I think the longing to be with Christ should not be considered a sin. In fact, it should be something that gives you encouragement and gives you hope. And it's something that the Lord sees in your heart with gladness. Kasi you're longing to be with Him. And that in itself is worship for the Lord Jesus Christ, diba? So I don't think it's a sin to long for Him, especially in our most down moments. Of course, if you consider that you, I don't like to say the word, pero you know, letting go of your own life, di ba? Of course, that one is sinful, especially kung wala ka namang ibang illness that can cause that kind of thinking. So I think longing to be with the Lord is one of the strongest drive for us Christians to wake up every day and serve Him and rejoice in our sufferings and to live out our Christian life, to be victorious here on this world, kasi nga it is that joy to be with Him that's driving us. So rather than looking at it negatively, let's look at it positively in a sense na ito po yung what we're hoping for. And if you are not excited to see the Lord Jesus Christ, like panahon po nung COVID, di ba? Everyone was so afraid to die. I'm talking about us, no? But the entire world was so afraid to die that COVID locked the entire world. Pero ever since po, since the beginning of history, makikita po natin, sino po ba yung mga tumulong nung bubonic plague, yung Black Death, yung Spanish Flu? Who were the people who stayed in the city to help the sick? It were the Christians. For them, serving the Lord and dying is much sweeter because they know in that service, in that act of service, they will be with the Lord Jesus Christ. So yung po, that's the way I see it po.
Ayun, thanks Doc June. Brother Jera, nawala na po ba ang kumakatok? May gusto pa po ba kayong i-add? Ayan.
Thank you, sorry po. Ayan, so sa akin po, same thing with Doc June, my answer is no, hindi po siya masama. Kasi lalo na po ngayon that we are living really in a sinful world, di ba? And only the presence of Jesus will comfort us, will give us the encouragement to continue in this life, na talagang yung presence lang ni Lord ang sagot sa lahat po ng tanong natin. Pero siguro yung context kasi, Doc, pwede rin kasi na, di ba, sometimes when we experience, kunyari, yung talagang sobrang tragedy ng buhay, that we are so down, disappointed, parang yun naman, I think, yung other extreme that minsan nasasabi natin, Lord, sana, ano, parang yung buhay, something parang kunin mo na yung buhay ko. Diba? Parang kunin mo na yung buhay ko. Siguro, medyo, ano po yun eh, medyo mahirap siyang alamin kasi it's in the heart. Pero kung ang pinanggagalingan niya na, Lord, sana kasama na kita. Kasi pagod na tayo, gusto mo na talaga, nasa heaven na tayo. Yung parang, you are really longing for His presence. I think okay lang po yun. Kasi the moment we say that words na, Lord, sana kasama na kita ngayon, that moment, si God, ipifeel ka na niya ng presence mo eh. The Holy Spirit will feel you immediately. So I think that's okay na talagang maglong tayo ng presence niya, especially during this time. So that's my answer.
Thank you so much po. May gusto pa po bang i-add si Brother Robert and Brother Art? Or clear yes, na po tayo? Yes po?
Gusto ko lang i-quote fully yung verse kasi napakaganda po niya in this context na tanong ni Sis Sylvia. Sa Philippians 1, sabi niya, "For I fully expect and hope that I will never be ashamed, but that I will continue to be bold for Christ as I have been in the past. And I trust that my life will bring honor to Christ, whether I live or die." Sabi niya, "For to me, living means living for Jesus. And dying is even better." Diba? Yun yung exact words ni Paul eh, which is I think many of us who are in the Lord that's hoping to be with Jesus, parang dying talaga is even better. You know, looking at all the trials that Paul went through, na talagang sabi niya, in this life, I will not be ashamed. I will be bold with Christ. And with that boldness, binugbog siya, na-shipwreck siya, almost left to die, stoned to death, nakagat ng ahas, lahat po ng pinagdaanan ni Paul. So, pagka sinasabi po niyang, "For me, dying is better," we can understand what he is talking about. And if we are really Christians living for Jesus right now, we can see the life in this world is difficult. And living a Christian life is a challenge. And only by the grace and the power of the Holy Spirit can we really be victorious. So dito pa sinabi ni Paul, living is, for me, dying is better. Pero sabi niya, but if I live, I can do more fruitful work for Christ. I hope that encourages us that po, na yes, we want to be with Jesus. But while, kasi I think I said this many times before, maraming gusto maging Christian para wala na daw problema ang buhay nila, ayos na. If that's the case, kukunin ka na ni Lord kasi sa heaven lang naman walang problema at walang sorrow at walang suffering. But the reason why you, each and every one of you, all 95 of us, 96, 97, are staying here on earth right now ay dahil may trabaho pa tayo para kay Jesus. And let's focus on that work.
Thank you, Doc June. So going back, may i-add pa po ba si Brother Robert and Brother Art? Here na po, next question.
Okay na po yun. Well said na po si Doc at saka ni Regera.
Alright, sige po, move po tayo sa next question. Who are the small and the great mentioned po sa verse 5? Are the small and the great mentioned po sa verse 5?
Ano yun na?
Sino pwede
ipunta? So, question po ito ni Ma'am Gigi Walhati. So, ayun po. If ever na-need nyo po ng follow-up or okay po.
Jera, I was waiting for Jera to answer. Sino daw yung great and small sa verse 5?
Apo. Dito po kasi yung sa sinasabi rito. Basahin ko po yung verse 5. And from the throne came a voice saying, "Praise our God, all you his servants." Okay? So he's referring po sa lahat ng servants, you who fear him, small and great. So ang understanding ko po dito dun sa small and great, I think in this time po kasi, there are some people na parang it's more on status sa society, na even you are just a normal people or you own a high position during this time, basta servant ka ni God, you will praise the Lord. So, yun po siya. Small and great.
Alright. So, I think wala naman ang i-add, no? If, ano, hinawa na from Kuya, ano, from Brother Jera na. Or baka may gusto pa pong i-add?
I think that's a very good one of the very good sign na remember sa great throne of judgment, we will all be judged. Lahat tayo i-judge. So maraming Christian nagtatanong, hala, i-judge pa rin pala ako kahit na kay Jesus na ako. Di ba? Parang bakit ganun? Akala ko ba wala nang judgment? But actually, our works will be judged by Christ. No? So there will be brothers and sisters who will be great in heaven, and there will be brothers and sisters who will not receive too much rewards in heaven. I think that has always been part of the story regarding our rewards. Tandaan niyo yung may 5 talents, binigyan ng 10 cities, yung may 2 talents, binigyan ng 5 cities, di ba? So, and I think God wants us to realize na we have rewards. And like nasabi ko na many times na marami sa ating Christian na sasabihin sa akin, Doc, okay na ako kung 75 lang ang passing grade, 75 lang ako sa heaven. Okay lang ako kahit wala na ako rewards sa heaven, okay lang. Pero actually, I think God is promising us rewards so that we can strive to be the best, no, while we are still in this world and really serve Him the most that we can. So we have many crowns, we have many leaderships when we go to heaven. Kaya I think there will really be great and there will be small. And I think that's just what a fair God will do, right? Diba? If I mean, Paul, who gave his entire life to Jesus, pwede ba yan na mas malaki ang rewards ko kaysa sa kanya? Na ako lang, si Doc Jun lang, na hindi nga ako nagpupunta sa pinuntahan ni Paul. Diba? Parang, so, I think that's one thing that we should also strive for. No? Let's not be a simple, you know, church-going Christian, but really serve the Lord fervently and with all our heart. And let's focus on the rewards that we will deserve in heaven.
Thanks, Doc Jun. Any additional po? Additional? Okay na po. Clear na? Okay, so let's move on po sa ating last question for tonight. Yan po. Paano po malalaman kung figurative ang isang bagay to interpret ang Book of Revelation? By Sir Andy. Paano nalaman kung figurative ang isang bagay to interpret ang Book of Revelation?
Si Kuya Art naman. Si Kuya Robert.
Ito po yung ano, small silence.
Actually, I'm waiting for yan.
Okay. Di ba po, before tayo nag-start ng Revelation, tinakal po ni Doc Jun yung mga numbers. Nandun yung 4, nandun yung 3, nandun yung 7, nandun yung 24. Yung po ay significant figures na nag-symbolize ng completeness. So, lagi po natin tatandaan na like for example, yung 7 angels, 7 rat, 7 spirit. If we're going to analyze, hindi naman 7 ang spirit ni God, di ba? So, it means it is the fullness or completeness of the spirit of God. Copy po.
Saka, maidagdag ko din na naipaliwanag din sa atin na minsan yung talata, kung babasahin mo yung mga susunod, ipinapaliwanag yung mga, halimbawa yung last week, yung senior ko sa inyo, yung mga sitting on the ano, yung sea, mga waters, mga ganon. Mga figurative yun eh. Pero pinaliwanag naman yung mga sumusunod na talata kung ano yun. Amen. Kaya malalaman natin kung ano yung mga hindi natin naunawaan. Kasi nga, si John, parating like, di ba? Parang it seems like, mga ganon, yung itsura. So sa madaling salita, in-explain din yung talata yung mga bagay na mga figurative. Kasi ang tanong, paano mo malalaman kung figurative? Kung halimbawa, yung beast, seven heads, may wings, yung mga ganon. So, yung mga yon ine-explain naman eh, yung seven spirit, so may number pa. So yon, that's how we will be able to understand yung passage as we move along sa mga susunod na talata. Minsan, other passages.
Yeah, so good. I agree sa sagot ni Kuya Robert saka ni Kuya Art. Pero Brother Andy, yung sa first meeting natin, I don't know if you were there. Kasi sabi ko nga, pag may nabasa kayo sa Revelation na medyo hindi nyo ganong maintindihan, the first thing you have to do, especially anywhere in the Bible actually, if there is something that you don't understand, you read the, usually the explanation is within the chapter. So i-explain yun. Pagka hindi nyo siya makita, it's within the book. So you have to read the entire book. Ah, yun pala yung sinasabi ng chapter 1. Nasa chapter 5 pala. Or it can be explained by the other parts, other books of the Bible. Diba yun yung sabi ko? So, the second concern with Revelation is tama si Kuya Andy though, na it is a apocalyptic book. And apocalyptic books ay punong-puno ng literary alliterations and similes and metaphors. No, sa kuminsan parang ano, totoo ba tong ano, seven heads? Totoo bang may five horns? Totoo bang may seven spirits si God? So those are true, but I also laid down the ground rules in our first meeting, di ba? Parang sa Book of Revelation, pagka city ang pagka babae ang pinag-usapan, it's usually talking about a city or a group of people, like the woman in the desert is Israel, and sino nga ba yun, si yan yung pinatay ngayon sa chapter 19, sorry ako, hindi ka
great prostitute.
The great prostitute naman are the group of people who do not follow Christ, di ba? And then I explained what the numbers meant. Pero tama ka, may tanong na, teka, so anong ibig sabihin ng number? So totoo ba yung 666? Totoo ba yung 144,000? And I tried to explain all of them. Now, in the end po, Kuya Andy, sa totoo lang, paano nyo nalaman na figurative to o hindi? Totoo lang, we really have to start, we have to really rely on the experts of the Bible. And yung mga talagang pinag-aralan yung Hebrew and Greek and kasama yung cultural ano of that time, no? What are the cultural deeds at that time? That's why they came, yeah, Babylon, sorry Ate Dal, Babylon. So that's why we came up with all of these things that can comprehensively explain what the Book of Revelation is all about. And that's why I think this itong Miyerkules on the study of Book of Revelation is really very helpful, kasi nga na-realize natin, yung pala ang ibig sabihin noon, di ba? Yun po.
Yun. Thanks, Doc June. Any additionals po? Okay na? Okay na po tayo? Clear na? All right. Clear na. And that ends our question and answer segment. Thank you, COS. And thank you for those na question po for tonight. Yan, what an interesting way to end our session, our last session for this meeting. Wow. All right, so hindi na po natin papatagalin pa. Yan, we'll now have our closing prayer to be led by Brother Jera Cesar.
Okay, let's pray po. Lord, hallelujah to your name, Father God. Jesus Christ, thank you. Thank you for your love. Thank you, Lord. You are an all-knowing God. You are in control of everything. Lord, maraming salamat for allowing us to learn again this evening. Thank you for all the people that you have sent today to attend this book study. I pray, O Lord, na lahat po kami, Panginoon, we live a life according to your will, Father. Help us always to have attitude to worship you. Ano man, Lord, yung sitwasyon namin sa buhay, Father God, we could still praise you, O Lord, knowing that you are with us, knowing that we have the assurance of salvation because of your Son, Jesus Christ. I pray, O Lord, as we end this meeting, O Lord, may your presence be upon us, Father God. And Lord, yung ginagawa namin sa buhay, I pray, God, that we'll always be glorify you, Lord, with our lives. Help us, Lord, to always fix our eyes on you. And do not allow the enemy, O Lord, to distract us, to steal, to kill, and to destroy the joy that we must have in your presence. Maraming salamat po. And we bring back to you, Lord, all the glory and praises. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.